Hello, Emily Holland musicians. It's me, Mr. Gessler. Welcome back to the Red Studio. I have been having fun this week with an app called Acapella, where you can sing with yourself. And I wonder if you recognize this song from 2013. One more time.
Da 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 da.
This is four times as awkward as watching yourself on video. Guys, you have been learning a lot of words in this past month. Subdivision, Takadimi, coronavirus, quarantine, social distancing. Some new words and some words you've heard before but now have kind of a new meaning. I read a fascinating article on BBC that kind of toyed with the idea of what it would be like if this coronavirus pandemic had happened in 2005. In 2005, there was no such thing as Instagram. Facebook was not very well known. Smartphones had not been invented yet. And you hadn't been invented yet. Most people didn't have the internet, and if they did, it was super slow. It's what we call dial-up, because it was actually done through a phone line. It took like a minute and a half to download a song, and actually it was a lot easier to find them illegally back then. Not that I would know from experience. Technology changes really fast, so in 2005, there were all these new words to learn. I mean, some new words, but also some words that we knew pretty well. So for example, a file used to be made out of paper, and now suddenly it was made of information, ones and zeros. We used to load boxes with stuff and store them, and now you would load a file with something and you would store it on a hard drive. Whatever that meant, I didn't know. Surfing was something that only happened at the beach, and now it was something you could do online, whatever that meant. Okay, to be fair, I was a little behind the times. But in 2005, there were two musicians from France. They were part of a genre called house music. It's kind of like dance disco. They were using the latest technology to make music. So synthesizers, vocoders, drum machines, keyboards. And they would wear these sort of futuristic costumes and alter their voices to sound subhuman. They called themselves Daft Punk. They took a lot of these new words and they strung them together into a song. And they made it robotically rhythmic, so it sounded sort of inhuman in a way. Ironically, this is on an album that's called Human After All. Look closely at these rhythms. See anything you recognize? Yeah, lots of Subdivision. Nothing but Subdivision. Last week we talked a lot about Subdivision, four sounds on a beat. You might not really like rap music or hip-hop music, it may not be your style, it's not really my style either, but it's really great for discussing rhythm because there are no high or low notes, only long and short sounds, which is what rhythm is. I want you to hear this bizarre song by Daft Punk because it too is only rhythms, and robotically even rhythms, because nothing can keep a steady beat like a machine can. The digitally altered voice is speaking, not singing. By the way, this song is called Technologic.
Technologic. Technologic. Technologic. Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, crash it, change it, mail, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick erase it, write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick rewrite it, plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, crack it, drop it, zip it.
Well, that was 2005. It's ironic that in 2013, the Pentatonix took this exact same song and brought it back around to the raw beauty of the human voice. They took these exact same rhythms and they added high and low pitches to them. So, one singer came in here on a D pitch. The rhythm is the same. Takadimi, 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 takadimi. And then another voice came in a little bit lower. Takadimi, 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 takadimi. And together they sound like this. And then while they continue on, a lower voice comes in down here. Together it sounds like this. And then another high voice comes in here. And together it sounds like this. But nobody has done it quite as well as they did.
Buy it, use it, break it, fix it, trash it, change it, mail, upgrade it, charge it, point it, zoom it, press it, snap it, work it, quick erase it, write it, cut it, paste it, save it, load it, check it, quick rewrite it, plug it, play it, burn it, rip it, drag and drop it, zip, unzip it, lock it, fill it, call it, find it, do it, put it, jam and lock it, surf it, scroll it, pause it, click it, cross it, back it, switch it, fade it, name it, rate it, tune it, print it, scan it, send it, touch, rename it, touch it, print it, play it, watch it, break the logic, one more time.
They won the Grammy Award in 2014 for Best Arrangement of Any Vocal or Instrumental Music, just by adding high and low pitches to a very simple rhythm. I mean, I'm making it sound easy. Choosing notes for a composition is not the easiest thing, and it's different from reading notes. We've done that before, it's called sight singing. But we haven't done it with subdivision yet. Look at this rhythm. What do you recognize? Mostly two or four sounds on each beat. There's one quarter note at the very end. These are not difficult rhythms for us now. The only difference is that we're seeing high and low pitches. It's been a while since we've done any sight singing, and this isn't really the place to practice it. But here's how I would tackle this one. I would read the rhythms first, like this.
Taka di mi ta di ta di ta di, taka di mi ta di ta di ta.
Then I would figure out the solfege, which is not too hard in this song. It's all do, mi, and sol, and a couple of re. This is not really what today's lesson is about, but let's dust off the old sight reading skills for a second. Pause the video on the next screen and see if you can figure out what the solfege is for these notes. Then see if you can read the solfege at the pace of the rhythm that's written in. Again, you've done this before. We're just adding some new beats that have four very quick sounds on them. Okay, now I'm going to sing the whole thing on solfege. The first do-do-do-do is going to be kind of awkward because we're jamming four do's into one beat. It'll sound something like this.
Do 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 mi so mi so mi do 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 mi re re do 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 mi so mi so mi re 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 mi re do.
Some of you already recognize this one, but in case you don't, let's go on and take a look at the lyrics. Now, just like with the Kanye West song that we looked at last time, we're going to take each syllable and apply one syllable to one note. So our first beat has four sounds. We're going to take our first four syllables that are underneath them. No one in the. It's all going to fit into the first beat, so we're going to say it pretty fast. So our rhythm for the first line is
taka di mi ta di ta di ta di.
We're going to put the words right on that same rhythm. No one in the house but Dinah, Dinah. Fair enough. But now we can apply our pitches to that as well. Starting with do.
Do 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 mi so mi so mi.
No one in the house but Dinah, Dinah.
Do 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 mi re re do. Taka di mi ta di ta di ta.
No one in the house but me, I know. That's going to be a lot easier in our real classroom. Let's look at another song, one you might not know. Like Technologic, this one is only rhythm. What do you recognize? There are lots of beats with four sounds, but there are some with three sounds. What is that? Can we go back to our Lego bricks for a second? Last time we took two eighth notes and replaced them with four 16th notes that took up the same amount of space, the space of one whole beat. What if we only did half the job? What if we disconnected these two eighth notes from each other and only replaced one eighth note with two 16th notes and left the other one intact? This is actually possible. We can combine one eighth note and two 16th notes, and they still fill up one beat. So we're going to join them together with a beam, like this. All of these notes together still take up the space of one beat. If you're inclined to do the math and add fractions, you can find out that this makes sense, or you can just look at the Lego bricks at the top of the screen. Okay, if you really want to do the math on the fractions, we can. 1/8 plus 2/16. First, we need a common denominator, or a common bottom number. We can do this in more than one way. I would like to reduce the fraction 2/16 to a simpler fraction, and we can do this by dividing both numbers by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1, 16 divided by 2 is 8, so we reduce 2/16 to 1/8. Hey, maybe that's why an eighth note takes up the same amount of space as 2/16 notes. Remember, when we add fractions, we're going to add the top numbers, the numerators, and the bottom number will carry over, it'll stay the same. 1/8 plus 1/8 is 2/8, and we can reduce this down the same way. Divide 2 by 2 and we get 1, divide 8 by 2 and we get 4, so 2/8 reduces to 1/4, or 1/4. Check the Legos. Yeah, this is math, but it's also music, so we have to ask, what is this going to sound like? Well, because the first note is now twice the size of the other notes, it's going to sound twice as long as the other notes. You may have noticed that ka in takadimi has disappeared. We'll sing ta long enough that it just hogs up all of ka's space. So we end up singing one long sound and two short sounds.
Ta-di-mi.
It's important to note here that the long sound is at the beginning of each one of these beats. Let's try a few beats in a row.
Ta-di-mi, 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 ta-di-mi.
Think of it this way, you're on a plane. These four chairs are one full beat, which has room for four 16th notes. You and your 16th note buddy are getting on the plane, and you're hoping your other two 16th note buddies can sit with you in your row. But 8th note not only takes one of the seats in your row, he takes two of them, just stretching himself out. Yeah, 8th note can be really selfish sometimes. He thinks he can pick on 16th notes just because he's twice their size. All the same, this is kind of cool, that we can combine an 8th note and two 16th notes into the same beat, and when you start to move them around, you change the sound of the music. We can actually combine them three different ways, but we're only going to look at two of them today. Let's go back to our two disconnected 8th notes. Instead of swapping out the second 8th note for two 16th notes, let's swap out the first 8th note for two 16th notes, and leave the second one there. Still one beat, right? The math is the same. But now the two short sounds are at the beginning, and the long sound is at the end. What's this going to sound like?
Ta-ka-di.
We say ta-ka-di because that selfish 8th note is hogging up the mi syllable. Yeah, 8th note can be downright mean. Thinks he can walk all over people. Let's try a few beats this way.
Ta-ka-di, 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 ta-ka-di.
Boy, these guys sure start to look the same after a while, huh? Take a close look and notice the difference between these two, because we're about to mix and match a little bit. Where is the longer sound in each group? Is it at the beginning? Is it at the end? I'm going to call this one ta-ka-di with the long sound at the end, and I'm going to call this one ta-di-mi with the long sound at the beginning, for obvious reasons. Okay, let's practice. I'm going to say the rhythm, and I'd like you to say it immediately after me. I'm going to say each rhythm twice before I move on to the next one. Here we go.
Ta-ka-di, 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 ta-ka-di. Ta-ka-di, 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 ta-ka-di. Ta-di-mi, 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 ta-di-mi. Ta-di-mi, 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 ta-di-mi. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi. Ta-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di. Ta-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di-mi. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di-mi. Ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di, ta-di-mi. Ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-ka-di, ta-di-mi. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-di-mi. Ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-ka-di, ta-di-mi.
Okay, now we're ready to look at a couple of pages from this song again. The 16th note groups, the ta-ka-di-mis, are pretty easy to identify. I see three of them on this first page. How many ta-di-mis do you see? That's the one with the long sound at the beginning and the two short sounds at the end. If you counted five, look again. One of them is flipped around. The long sound is at the end. I'm gonna say a line and you say it back, cool? Here we go.
Ta-di-mi, ta-di-mi, ta-ka-di-mi, ta-di-mi. dee-me, ta dee-me, taka dee-me, ta dee-me. Taka dee-me, taka dee-me, taka dee, ta dee-me. Taka dee-me, taka dee-me, taka dee, ta dee-me.
Good, here's the second page. Look it over a little bit before we continue. A couple of ta dee-mes, but no taka dees this time. Then a single ta at the end with an eighth rest. First me, then you. Don't get lazy on me now.
Taka dee-me, ta dee-me, taka dee-me, taka dee-me. Taka dee-me, ta dee-me, taka dee-me, taka dee-me. Taka dee-me, ta dee-me, taka dee-me, ta. Taka dee-me, ta dee-me, taka dee-me, ta.
Great, we're ready to add some lyrics. We're going to do the same thing where I say it first and then you say it back. But the first time I'll do it on taka dee-me, the second time I'll do it on lyrics. Ready?
Ta dee-me, ta dee-me, taka dee-me, ta dee-me.
Lean with it, rock with it, when we gonna stop with it?
Taka dee-me, taka dee-me, taka dee, ta dee-me.
Lyrics that mean nothing we were gifted with thought, is it? Now obviously the lyrics imply that the song goes on. Yes, it does. That second page that we were reading has more lyrics to it. I'd like you to hear how it all sounds together. The actual tempo is more like 90 beats per minute, so quite a bit faster. This is a song by 21 Pilots. I don't think they would consider themselves to be hip-hop music, but like hip-hop and rap music, they often speak the lyrics rather than singing them. So it's just rhythm. It's no distinct high and low pitches.
Lean with it, rock with it, when we gonna stop with it? Lyrics that mean nothing we were gifted with thought. Is it time to move our feet to an introspective beat? It ain't the speakers that bump hearts, it's our hearts that make the beat. Lean with it, rock with it, when we gonna stop with it? Lyrics that mean nothing we were gifted with thought. Is it time to move our feet to an introspective beat? It ain't the speakers that bump hearts, it's our hearts that make the beat. Lean with it, rock with it, when we gonna stop with it? Lyrics that mean nothing we were gifted with thought. Is it time to move our feet to an introspective beat? It ain't the speakers that bump hearts, it's our hearts that make the beat. Lean with it, rock with it, when we gonna stop with it? Lyrics that mean nothing we were gifted with thought. Is it time to move our feet to an introspective beat? It ain't the speakers that bump hearts, it's our hearts that make the beat.
So before we return to high and low pitches, we're going to continue talking about rhythm. There's actually a lot more to explore. One more thing before we go. When you complete the Google Classroom assignment, you will see this little submit button. If you click the submit button and see a screen like this, your work has been submitted. You can view your score, and if you don't like it, sometimes you're allowed to go back and try the assignment again. Now, a number of you are concerned because the assignment is still marked as missing. That's okay. If you got this confirmation page, you're fine. But if it bothers you, I think it would bother me, here's what you can do. Click Mark as Done or Turn In, whichever button you see, and you'll see this scary warning. Mark as Done? You didn't attach work for this assignment, so your teacher will just see that it's done! That's okay, mark it as done. I have other ways of knowing if you submitted the work. But so far, I'm seeing much better turnout and much better scores on this last assignment, so thank you very much for applying yourselves. Next time, we'll be talking about another big word, syncopation. That's when eighth note hogs up the two middle seats. See you then.